As Kriegsmarine submarine U-1206 left Kristiansand to conduct her first war patrol one cloudy day in April of 1945, the flushing of a toilet proved her tragic demise. The warship was a revamped Type VIIC submarine with several technological innovations, one of which included a new toilet mechanism that allowed her to save precious weight in space. However, when a sailor failed to activate the system correctly, the submarine started to flood, catching the crew entirely by surprise. As chlorine gas started to leak out from the submarine's batteries, 27-year-old Captain Karl-Adolf Schlitt had to react quickly and make a difficult decision, risking being spotted by British patrols surrounding the area. Submarine warfare. U-boats were the naval submarines used by Germany during the First and Second World Wars, and even though they were produced in limited numbers during both conflicts, they proved to be highly effective for the most part. Although the Kriegsmarine expected to sink dozens of Allied warships with the submarines, the British and American forces were quick to neutralize the threat by traveling in large convoys. Still, the U-boats served as an effective deterrent to Allied offensive incursions into German-controlled waters and the European shores. The German submarines were primarily feared because of their commerce raiding or economic warfare capabilities, which ultimately became a naval blockade against Allied shipping. And they mostly targeted merchant vessels carrying war supplies from the United States, Canada, and United Kingdom to specific territories of Great Britain and the Soviet Union. During the first years of World War II, the U-boats reigned supreme and almost succeeded at draining Great Britain out of supplies and isolating the Allied nations from each other. But the Anglo-American navies eventually learned how to defend themselves from these hunters by developing advanced radar technology, breaking the Enigma machine, and operating with convoys and escorts. The U-boat operations then became riskier and more challenging, but that did not prevent submarine captains from accomplishing perilous sabotage operations across the world until the Normandy landing of June 1944, which turned the tide of the Battle of the Atlantic. Still, U-boat wolf packs went as far as the Gulf of Mexico, the coasts of Brazil, the eastern United States, Canada, and the Arctic to get rid of any commercial or military vessel that dared venture into desolated waters. The Kriegsmarine also built dozens of heavily fortified U-boat pens throughout Europe to quickly get back into the action after maintenance or resupply, or simply to find shelter from enemy ships or aircraft. The pens, or wolf dens, were built with several thick layers of concrete that made them shockproof against conventional artillery from warships and aircraft bombloads. Only the British Tallboy bomb developed by the Royal Air Force led to the end of these impressive cave-like structures where the precious U-boats were stored and taken care of. Evolution. As the war dragged on and the British and American forces figured out cunning ways to eliminate the U-boat menace using radar, sonar, and the Enigma machine, the submarine doctrine had to adjust, and so did the submarines themselves. There were over 15 different types of submarines envisioned by the Kriegsmarine, but not all of them made it out of the drawing boards. The Type 1 and 2 prototypes were the first submarines produced by the German Navy during the post-war period, and they were based on Finnish and Spanish submarines designed by undercover German military engineers. Meanwhile, Types 3 and 4 submarines never materialized, but had some very unique features. For instance, Type 3 was a mine layer, capable of carrying up to 50 mines and two small motor torpedo boats. Some of these ideas would later be integrated into the Type 10 cargo submarines. Type 4, on the other hand, was intended to be a resupply and repair U-boat that would meet other submarines at sea to resupply them with food, water, torpedoes, and spare parts that later evolved into the Type 14 U-boat. The Type 5 submarine would eventually become Germany's first midget U-boat and the Type 17 coastal submarines powered by hydrogen peroxide propulsion systems. Then there was Type 9, which was specially modified U-boats capable of long-range operations. Out of all the different types of German submarines, the most produced was the Type 7 U-boat, which became the main force of the Kriegsmarine wolf packs. Over 700 models were built during the war, and it was heavily modified throughout the conflict. Type 7C submarines. Type 7 was based on several incomplete submarine types, and was initially designed in the mid-1930s when the Third Reich began working on its new generation of submarines. These U-boats were popular within the Kriegsmarine due to their crash-dive speed, making them more maneuverable during combat. They were also robust, carrying torpedoes and a 3.5-inch deck gun with more than 220 rounds. Type 7 was powered on the surface by two six-cylinder, four-stroke M6V 4046 diesel engines, generating over 2,000 horsepower. In addition, two double-acting electric motors gave the submarine a total of 750 horsepower when submerged, while on surface level, their maximum speed was 32 kilometers per hour, in contrast to 14 kilometers when submerged. Their maximum depth was 230 meters. These submarines displaced more than 800 tons when submerged, and over 750 when surfaced. Their length was 67 meters, with almost 10 meters in height. The 7C version was the workhouse of the Wolfpacks. It had an estimated range of 8,500 miles and included an array of technological innovations that were not incorporated into U-boats until very late in the war. Some of these novelties included the active sonar, snorkel, and a unique German creation, the state-of-the-art high-pressure toilet that became the center of attention when U-boat 1206 flooded because of it. Disposing of waste. As World War II was coming to an end, the Kriegsmarine was still sending U-boat crews to try and tilt the tide in Germany's favor. Such was the case of U-boat 1206, one of the last German submarines to be put into service. This Type 7C submarine was laid down in June of 1943 and was commissioned in March of 1944 to participate in training exercises. Under the command of 27-year-old Captain Lieutenant Karl-Adolf Schlitt, this Type 7C submarine then successfully completed her training patrol in the North Sea on March 28, 1945. A few days later, U-boat 1206 was fitted with a snorkel underwater breathing apparatus and left the Horten Naval Base on Kristiansand on April 2, 1945 to conduct her first war patrol. The submarine's emblem, a white stroke on a black shield with green beak and legs, was suddenly lost on the horizon as the crew ventured off to the seas. U-1206 was equipped with an innovative high-pressure toilet that allowed the crews to use it while moving through the depths of the ocean. This state-of-the-art toilet was very different when compared to the ones used by British and American crews. While the Britons did not have a problem storing human waste in septic tanks aboard the vessel, the Germans preferred to save precious weight in space. Consequently, the Kriegsmarine developed a high-pressure system that ejected waste directly into the sea as if it were a sewage torpedo. However, the system had a fault. It could only be used when the submarine was near the surface. And if a sailor wanted to answer nature's call, he had to use buckets the old-fashioned way until the U-boat surfaced. Late in the war, U-boats spent most of their time underwater to avoid detection. These circumstances did not help in clearing the stench that permeated the U-boat, including the smells of diesel, body odor, cigarettes, and human waste. Still, the sailors got used to it and never allowed the scent to disturb their duties. The unique toilet system was not easy to use, and a specialist was required to operate the complex system. Formerly called a WC waste disposal manager, the crew liked to call this highly trained sailor the shit man. A series of valves had to be operated in a particular order to avoid any problems, and Captain Schlitt would find this out the hard way on April 14, 1945. Sunk by a toilet. After 9 days into the mission, it is said that Captain Schlitt went to the toilet but failed to operate the flush correctly, calling a specialist for assistance. Unfortunately, the sailor accidentally turned the wrong valve, and the toilet cabin began to fill with human waste and seawater. The stenching liquid then began to leak into the battery compartment located below, provoking a chemical reaction that released chlorine gas. Captain Schlitt then ordered his men to fire all the torpedoes to liberate the ship of unnecessary weight and surface quicker. But when this embarrassing moment appeared to have ended, the situation got worse. As the U-boat surfaced, it was spotted by Royal Air Force aircraft. The Britons fired instantly, which led the crew to scuttle the submarine after destroying all valuables on board. Captain Schlitt ordered the crew to make way for the shores of Peterhead, Scotland, where they had surfaced, but out of the 50 crewmen, 4 did not make it to the coast. The rest of the men were taken prisoner by British forces once they reached land. And although the most popular version of the story blames the captain for causing this incident, Schlitt himself wrote another statement that read, quote, "I was in the engine room when, at the front of the boat, there was a water leak. What I've learned is a mechanic had tried to repair the forward WC's outboard vent. The engineer who was in the control room at the time managed to make the boat buoyant and surfaced, despite severe flooding. Meanwhile, the batteries were covered with seawater. Chlorine gas started to fill the boat. We were then incapable of diving or moving. At this point, British planes and patrols discovered us. I let the boat sink." In May of 2012, divers found U-1206, buried 86 meters below Cruden Bay in Aberdeenshire. The submarine was in excellent conditions after 7 decades, but forever cursed by the stench of failure. Thank you for watching our video. Please like and subscribe to our Dark Documentaries channels to find more exciting historical content. And let us know in the comments below what you think of the strange demise of U-boat 1206, caused by a malfunction in the toilet system.